Alright then, so Ambrose Island is our next target. There's three variants, which are regular, sunset, and daytime. There's no variance to the map in general, I don't think, but even lighting changes are good when you're playing the same maps over and over. Now, prestige objectives. We've got pacify baseball bat, time disguises or collateral kill explosion. Now, we've got sniper rifle kill as one of our other challenges. Off the top of my head, I don't know where you can get a baseball bat or a sniper rifle in this map. So what I'm thinking of doing is bringing both in with me, even though it's incredibly ill-advised. Before we go, we'll just take a quick look at our luchador kitties, because why wouldn't you have luchador kitties if that's an option? They look amazing. And now away we go. Let's see which variant of Ambrose we're getting today. Let's take the hearse.
Jesus, talk about foreshadowing.
They're on high alert. It's not going to be easy. Be careful, 47.
I need help!
Okay, that's an interesting start. Let's get this guy into the bush before anything happens.
Oh, Lord.
Okay,
why
someone saw
dragging
that.
Dragging a dead person? That's
he's not,
really...
He's not dead, my friend.
Sick.
He's just on the floor. So are you. Now, let's get you in the same bush. And let's get ourselves a hippie disguise. Because why not? Okay, who are you? You're the pirate guy. We'll pick up our wrench. Pick up a key.
Hello.
You can go in the same pile of bushes. This is already escalating spectacularly. Right, your rifle. There's a briefcase. We'll grab that. So at least one of those guys isn't properly in the bush. Hence them being spotted. Now, where's our baseball bat gone? That guy doesn't seem to spot anything untoward. Fantastic. That's a good start. Let's grab the baseball bat. Let's head down this way. Perhaps? No, that leads towards... I mean, maybe we just take the guard disguise at this point. Which one's the guard? There he is. This way we can carry both of our items. And all will be well. Let's have a look at our target, shall we? So we've got four of them, and they're all down around Farrah's place, or thereabouts. That's going to be tricky. But not impossible. So we've got a sniper rifle kill. Got pacify one with a baseball bat. That's probably the first thing we should do, is pacify with a bat. I'd like it to be one of the first things we do, at least. Now, there's a guard usually over here. So, do we deal with this lad? There is a risk that he heads up and finds other people. So, there'd normally be two pirates hanging around here. I guess one of them was the first guy we bopped. So we should be safe to bop this lad and then drag him around the corner. Because, yeah, this is a nice handy spot around here to just dump an unconscious dude. And we'll grab ourselves a poisonous flower whilst we're here. So, we'll grab our briefcase, we'll grab his gun, and we'll just sling that around here as well. This really was a poor idea to bring two large weapons, but it's not the end of the world. Now, two of the targets are down by the docks themselves. Are they going to be a good place to start? Or should they be at the end simply because they are closer to an exit? Now we can sneak around here. We could climb up, but we don't want to be doing much climbing whilst we've got all of our gear on us. There's guards around here that'll see through my disguise, if I remember rightly. That guy would. But he's wandering off. That guy's just having a pish, so we'll leave him be. Now, it's Target Fest over here. You are...
Keep your eyes on the toy soldiers. They're up to something.
You're just like a handyman type dude, aren't you? Your outfit might be worth grabbing at some point down the line. For now, I really want that pacifier. And then maybe we can hide the bat somewhere. I don't think anyone's going to come in here, really. So this could be a good place to drop the bat. Although, yeah, like I've said, it doesn't matter if we lose the bat.
It looked like mostly surface damage to me.
Okay, there's a lot of people around here that recognise us. So, that's one of our targets. That guy who recognises us over there. So, is there anywhere where we can really deal with that guy? I don't think so. Not what this guard is about. Let's see. Oh yeah, we've got kill only targets. I should remember that. Because that's useful to know if I'm knocking people out near the water.
What's up, sir?
Nothing, friend. Now. Okay, so you're one of the militia types. And you're coming this way. There's nowhere around here to hide bods, are there? But now that you've left, is it a good time to deal with him, or is he going back indoors? He's going in. And then, so he goes between the chair and in there, I guess. Now, potentially, we could lure him out here. No, we've lured a guard. That's not what we need.
Nothing out of the ordinary here.
Now, what though if we lure the guard again?
We might have a possible disturbance. I'm moving to investigate.
Are there too many people there watching us? Maybe.
Why does this always happen? Why does this open?
I got
it! What's this?
What?
You just knocked him out, you jackass!
Stop it! Shit!
Asshole!
Oh shit, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to do that. And now, yeah, there we go. Campaign failed. Dagnammit.
How unfortunate. It rather appears that you ran out of luck. Back to the drawing board, 47.
That wasn't luck, Diana. That was running out of brains.
I'm sure your next execution will be perfect.
I'm not sure at all.
Let me know when you're ready.
And now I've lost my most legendary of sniper rifles, which is a shame. But hey-ho, let's get some clothes on and let's try another mission or two. Because the plan was to show off the mod. I mean, the plan was to show off the mod and complete the campaign. But one out of two is not bad, right? Right? So let's take the middle item in the crate. It is not a lockpick. Sad times. And let's see where we might want to go to have a look at some new levels. New York doesn't have any variants, sadly. Dubai also doesn't have any variants. But everywhere else does. So, Colorado, Marrakesh, Miami? That could be fun. Espionage? Yeah, that's not going to work. But hey-ho, here we are. Start with Colorado, because why not? No firearms, hide target bodies, don't blow your disguise. Tricky. Tricky all round. Pacify with a baseball bat. Again, thanks, game. Timed hide and seek isn't too bad on Colorado. So, hide target bodies, don't blow your disguise, no firearms. Let's see, do we have anything sharp up here that we can bring along? Any kitchen knives or whatnot? Would be nice. We've got the hatchet out back, but I think that's not really an item we can bring. We've got the grape knife. Just so we've got a lethal throw item. Lovely.
You know what to do, 47.
We know what to do. What we should do is be more patient than we were. I forgot rule one of Freelancer, which is be patient. Now, let's have a look around, shall we? There's got to be a disguise around us somewhere that we can snag. Oh, we're near the water tower. Good. That's perfect. Now, we don't need to worry if we accidentally kill someone, because we don't have kill only targets. So, where's our grape knife? There it is. Who are you? You're not the point, man. You're just the other guy. And we've missed our opportunity to shank you there. Never mind, eh? I was just wary about being spotted through the window. I don't even know if they can spot you through the window when you're on the box. I'm going to assume not, because you crouched down. But let's see. Ah, this time we've got the point, man.
No,
that's
that
good. He's going to turn that off. Down he goes. And there we go. One disguise. We'll take his gun just because it's probably a good idea to have one. And can we pull our grape knife out of his head? We can. Perfect. Gotta remember the old hide and seek. It's definitely the easiest of the timed missions. Right, so where are our targets? There's one very close by in the North Orchard, and one upstairs in the mansion.
Not to mention the quality of the people.
So you're one of them. Is there anyone else hanging around here? There's that guy over there. Can we get away with this? We can. Good. So now we can definitely poison our target and move him. Is that good for us? Maybe. Is it even necessary? Or could we just distract him over here with a throw? Well, either way, he's feeling sick in a minute. Oh no, he's just chilling. No, he's going to have a sit down. Okay. Maybe if we lure him with an apricot.
Huh?
Did that get him?
Dispatch.
Yeah, it did.
Just heard something fishy.
Now, you two guards, please carry on. Good. He's coming over here. Down he goes.
Excellent work, 47.
And into the box. And we'll join him in the box just to reset the timer. Lovely. Now, on we go to target number two. Much as I love this disguise, it's got very few enforcers. We are going to need a better one to get into the house.
Hey man, you can't come through it right now. Get back to your station.
Or am I looking in the wrong place? No, he's over in the barn now. Has he moved from there to the barn? Who does that?
How are you?
Is he following Pavati or something like that.
That would be Burgess, the sharpshooter. He's point man in the Mexico operation.
Oh, he's following by a ram or something? The elusive target. We're on the elusive target version of the map. And he is one of his guards. Eesh. Right, so they are going to end up going into the house. Maybe we do want to change our clothes. Right, those guys are not really paying a lot of attention. So let's put on this outfit and sneak on in. Upstairs does have places to hide, but it also has guards that can recognize us. Alright, so in the cupboard we go. So this lad roams around. He comes into the house and then he leaves the house again. Does he come out here? He might do. I know that guy probably comes out. We got anything non-lethal we can chuck about? No. Have I backed myself into a silly place? Maybe.
Identify yourself.
Hi, friend. I'm just gonna come over here. Are you gonna follow me? You are.
This is your final warning.
Right, so we'll deal with you.
Eyes open.
Oh, someone's. Come in, command. Found a victim. The crime scene is real fresh. Right, so they're on to me. That's fine. Let's deal with that, shall we? Right, that guy is just chilling. Which is nice. Now guards are roaming about. As you might expect. So let's just move away from them back into the video game room. How's it going, boys? Kane and Lynch again. Those guys love that game. Right, the searching is complete. So, let's see. That guy's still just kipping. Didn't notice a bunch of heavily armed dudes stroll in and wonder about a murder that was happening. That guy is now just in a body bag, but they don't seem to know what to do with him. But I believe taking that guy out is the trigger to allow the elusive target to just stand on this balcony. Could be wrong about that. But if that's the case, then we could get rid of him. And if we get rid of him, maybe that causes his guard to go somewhere else and do something else. It's kind of unfortunate that we've got the elusive target guard. Because, yeah. There's at least two guards following the target. And he's going to roam all around the place. Pretty much. So it might take him a while to get back to any particular point, which might make setting traps a little difficult. Maybe to be on the safe side, we'll deal with this lad on the bed. Just because we can. Oh yeah, I've also got the timer. So we'll focus on that as well. Can we get into the safe? We can. Is there any reason to do so? We get a ledger. Does that help us in any way? I don't know. There's a thought. What if I drop a gun? And then the elusive target sees it and he says, oh, hey guys, you should come check out this gun. It says no firearms, but this isn't using them in the way that the game intended. It's thinking outside the box. Now, he does have four separate guards though, so it could take a while. to get the correct one. And of course, the one that we need is the one that recognizes us. And then, am I right in thinking he comes up the stairs? I could be thinking about an entirely incorrect elusive target here, but I'm pretty sure he comes up the stairs now. Yeah, here they all come. So he's going to go into a different room. Okay. Right. I mean, the nearest guard is the one that we want, right? And then there's other people around. What if we... Can we hold this door open with a briefcase? Oops, that's not a briefcase, that's a baseball. And the answer is no. And now they're going back downstairs. Damn it. And none of them are hearing that. Okay. Right, so we need a new plan. Or two.
Better, I think. I'll have another go.
You got it.
Ah. He's in here now and his guards are outside. So where are they going? They're not even following the guy I thought they were following. I thought this guy was the elusive target.
72nd Strategic Air Wing.
But he's still in there, so... Who are they following? And also, is it a good idea to take out the cameras whilst we're in here? Is it even possible with this many lads about the gaff? So you come here and deal with that. And whilst you're doing that, I will deal with this. And then head on out. Right, so that's the surveillance out of the way at least. This is a start, but now we need to go find out where our guard friend is going. I'm thinking it's going to be real tricky to get high target bodies. We could potentially get everything else. Although, don't blow your disguise could be tricky.
Need anything?
What you got for sale, my friend? Let's see, you haven't got my super cool rifle. Sadly. You got an ice pick, though. And you got a crowbar. We definitely need that. Be nice to get my wrench back. Can't afford the ice pick now, though, sadly.
Come back if you need more.
Now, what would happen if we start crushing people? Is this going to cause a big problem, or is this going to eventually lure over our man? If there's a big pile of bodies, maybe he'll be the next one to come over afterwards. Because yeah, it's not using firearms, it's not blowing our disguise. It's just making a bit of a mess. And it's clearing an area of guards as well, which is nice. So yeah, here comes another. Give him the old crushinator. Any more? Situation's back to normal, says some rando guard. Okay. So yeah, sooner or later, elusive target might make his way over. Is anyone going to notice if we bonk this lad and stick him in the crate? Almost, but not quite. That makes me worry that we're not going to be able to do the same and get away with it with our target. I feel like if we do wait long enough, though, he's going to bob over. Yeah, here they come. Are they going to see the chaos over here? The suspicious pile of bodies? And think, maybe I want some of that. Let's see. Is he going to look in this direction? Or is he going to go into the building? He's going into the building. What does that do for us? Not a lot with the guard being his first in line, I don't think. Sod it. I think in the interests of not spending the rest of my life on this level, we're just going to try and take our target out and run away. So maybe we just crushed all those dudes for no clear reason. But I guess that's fine. It's too far away to throw anything out from here. We could trespass. God, it's very dark in here. That's not going to look good on the old tubes. Right, they're making their way back out. So maybe we sneak over and nip through this window. Oh, hello.
Help. Please, help me.
Someone's found someone. Where are you off to, my man?
Maybe it's time to wake up.
Maybe that guy doesn't give a damn because you're not a guard, you're a supplier. That's an interesting interaction. Right, so we've got a guy to move.
Huh?
Places that he wouldn't normally be moving.
What?
This could be interesting. Yeah, everyone over there is doing their thing. Is anyone watching our guard friend?
God.
Is he going to come over here now? No, he's not. Have we just thrown away our only lethal item? Maybe. Oh, we can get it back. Good. Now.
Excuse me, I think I found... This is Sentry 2. How got me over?
Hell?
Send out Big Cat to my 12 for recon.
Who can we take care of here?
Duct tape ain't gonna fix that.
Can't quite get our man. But maybe he's the one who...
You heard it too. Give me intel on that.
Heard that. Yes, he is. Right. So, what if we sneak around here, close that.
Well done, 47. This will surely be a blow to the syndicate.
Right. I don't know if we got away with that.
Collect yourself. I'll be in touch.
Maybe we did get away with that. Jeez, how did we get away with that? Is the question.
Cool stuff.
But yeah. I mean, the main thing is, we got away with that. Now, can we hide the body? Is the question. Do we just need to wait until everyone's finished moving around and doing their thing? Should we wait anywhere in the vicinity of the body? Or should we get ready to run? Which way are you dragging that corpse? Is everyone being dragged into there? I think they are. So maybe we just wait around and let this settle down. Right. Now the only question is, are those two lads going to see anything? Because sometimes the guards have got really long sight ranges when it comes to bodies being dragged about the gaff. But we're going to have to try it. It's tense. But we've done it. And that, apparently, is how you successfully get away with killing and hiding one guard when he's being followed about the gaff by three other guards and a dude. How we got away with that, Lord knows, but we did. And now we've got a little pile of bods in here. We've got a nice little pile of guns. Do we have these guns back at base? Almost certainly. Are we taking an extra one with us? Yeah, why not? I do enjoy Colorado, though. It's been made hugely better by the fact that you can hide in bushes and whatnot. Because it was a little short on hiding spots back in 2016. But now it's great. The only problem with it is that it is a bit flat. But aside from that, I do really enjoy it. And for now, we say farewell to it.
Excellent, 47. If you feel the urge to do a little interior decorating, please do so.
Maybe we will, Diana. Maybe we will. But for now, we'll drop off some of the gear we don't need. We'll see if we got a lockpick. Nope, flash phone. But we'll take it, because as previously mentioned, that's going to help fill up the slots in this middle thing. This middle briefcase. And with it doing that, that's going to allow us to get to our lockpick quicker. But we have now got the crowbar back and the wrench. Both useful tools. And I think we've got time for one more mission today, so let's see what we've got. Marrakesh, I was looking forward to doing. Miami is great for showdowns. But am I going to record any more after this? Because it'd be nice to record another Marrakesh, just in case we get a house built on sand, which I do enjoy. Poison target dart gun, don't change disguise, ooh. And eliminate guards with an SMG. Well, we can do that bit, for sure. So, we've only got one dart gun left, which we'll bring along. And we will bring an SMG. Should we bring another ornamental? We've lost one today. Why not bring another? What's the harm? And let's see, collateral kill firearms though. I mean, that would suggest bringing a shotgun instead. So maybe we drop the big subby, we bring the shotgun, and then we bring a little subby. Little sub. That helps get the job done. Now let's go see which version of Marrakesh we've got today.
Welcome to Marrakesh.
It's regular Marrakesh.
The syndicate is currently in operation.
Never mind, here.
Find the target and eliminate. You know what to do, 47.
We know what to do. We've done it before. Now, we normally bring a regular lockpick, though, when we do this. Can we lure anyone out without it? May as well bring out the old gun, just because it's nice to have. That guy's not looking at us, so maybe we do a bit of that. And then maybe we can lure him over. There's a guard that leans out of that window. Here he comes. So we can toss the old briefcase. Get the wrench ready. Get ourselves at least a basic disguise. Now, we'll leave the AK there. And let's have a think. Targets are... well, the one target is in the consulate. Okay. They are, however, in the garage, so we don't actually need a top tier disguise. But it'd be nice to have one, just because it's just generally more useful. So what if we do a bit of that? And then drag him out of the way, grab his gun, and drag that out of the way too. Military officer, there we go. Doesn't really matter if these guys are seen. especially if they're dead. Are you going to see them? You might cause a ruckus if you do see them. So maybe just to be on the safe side. Oh, I forgot about it. Do not change disguise. What an idiot I am. Right, no one's around, are they? So maybe we'll throw you in a bin. And at least we've cleared that challenge. It's a shame we didn't get a house built on sand. Because that is one of my favourite maps in the series, the night version of Marrakesh. But you can't have everything. Such is the nature of having multiple maps available to you. Is that sometimes you get the ones you want, sometimes you won't. Right, so there's our target. He roams about the place. He doesn't recognise us by the look. No, he's just one of many guards around here, and there are many. But he's also the one that's closest to over here. So maybe we could lure him in and lure one of the others in as well. But then again, maybe we can just lure them all with the radio.
Yeah, this is shaping up to be a major.
Now, can this go well for us? Or will it go badly?
Deep breaths, in through the nose, out through the mouth.
That didn't look as though it went well. Yeah. Somebody definitely saw something suspicious there. We got a strangler on the loose. Shoop a doop doop doo. Well. You lot worry about the strangler. And I will come over here and dart gun our dude, perhaps.
Wait, what's going on with the gun? Someone stalking you or what?
Maybe. Right, where's he going? What is he up to?
Get the jitters, huh?
It's just...
What's going on, buddy?
We have a man that needs to be set straight. He's making a real mess out there.
I need to know exactly what he looked like and what he was wearing.
I don't know,
Right. That's one thing done. However, collateral could be tricky because... Yep.
Go, go, go. Watch out!
Oh god. Wait, don't stand by the car.
Move to better positions.
Because that can happen. At least we might get a good chance of a collateral kill here.
Hey. Hey. Wake up. Anybody in there?
Right. That guy doesn't care. That's nice. We are kind of running out of dudes to get the collateral with, which is a shame. But we're making a nice little bod pile, which is always fun. Ah, here comes target. Nice.
This will surely be a blow to the syndicate.
That's how you get collateral kill firearms. And yeah, let's go, shall we? Nothing going on up there, friend. Yeah, you keep doing your job. Good lad. So yeah, aside from change in disguise, That went smooth as silk. I mean, yeah, a few bodies have been found. Here and there, you know, hanging about. Not the end of the world. Oh yeah, yeah, a few more bodies. Nothing to do with us, Guff. We're just carpet shopping. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Just gonna go buy a nice rug. Maybe see another shopkeeper while we're here.
I got some cool stuff.
What you got, friend? Screwdriver. Oh! Can we afford... We can afford both the dart guns. That's the reward you get for being a good boy and playing the mission with a big shotgun. And now, see you later, Marrakesh. Let's see, can we top it all off by getting a lockpick? Nope, oil canister. But that's fine, we're whittling down the number of items we need to get our pointy friend back. And yeah, I think that'll do for now. So hopefully it showed off the mod in a cool light. I mean, we got to see the Noodle Massacre in Chongqing, for example. We got to see Nighttime Colorado with the elusive target. So yeah. Could have certainly gone worse. And once again, thank you very much for watching. Maybe I'll play some more down the line. Who knows? Could happen. Might not. We'll see. We will see. It's done pretty well compared to a lot of the other stuff on the channel, so there's certainly a possibility. But for now, 47 and I will bid you adieu. Thanks for watching, friends.